Hello, Jeremy Chapman coming to you live from the Microsoft 365 Community Conference in Las Vegas. Right now, we're going to talk about something brand new, SharePoint Embedded, and I'm joined by Yogesh. Welcome.
Hi, Jeremy.
Now with the Microsoft 365 Community Conference, tell us what's the most kind of important aspect of coming to conferences like this for you.
So, as a product manager, product builder, you know, I love to connect with the community and kind of ground on the problems they are facing because that informs the roadmap. So that's basically the obvious outcome usually for me. But it's also connecting with the community, right? It's a community conference and just the vibe and the energy you get, and you kind of take it back to your team and kind of infuse it for the rest of the year. So yeah, so I just love connecting with people in general.
And you get unique feedback here, a lot of unique questions, things that you don't necessarily see back in Redmond coming from these different contacts that you're making here. I see that as well.
Absolutely.
So we're talking about SharePoint Embedded. So why don't you explain now first, what is SharePoint Embedded and what does it actually do right now?
So at the very core, SharePoint Embedded is a way for you to store your files and documents. But it's way more than that, right? It's in its most basic form, a headless SharePoint.
Right.
But you get the power of Copilot and the full collaborative features that SharePoint brings on top of the enterprise-grade IT capabilities of Microsoft 365. Right. So once your application hosts the content within SharePoint Embedded, you not only get all the document management capabilities, but they are AI ready from the very get-go, right? So in this age of AI, you want to be AI-centric, AI-native application.
Right.
And that's the unique thing about SharePoint. You don't have to build the document management, you don't have to build your AI stack, and you don't have to worry about the IT capabilities. Your application is ready.
Okay, so speaking of all the IT capabilities, I know a lot of people are probably wondering, for data security, for identity, role-based access controls, all of these things, does it work in that environment?
Absolutely. So in the enterprise readiness aspect, you know, you get the intra-led authentication out of box. And with that, you get the graph awareness, right? So the content is already graph aware, permission aware. So you don't have to build any of your ACLs. And the content in SharePoint Embedded inherits all the security and compliance features, including Purview, e-discovery, audit, DLP, sensitivity labels, all of those naturally percolate to the content in SharePoint Embedded. So your applications don't need to build any of those features.
So the policies that you build, for example, in Purview to say, if I find sensitive information should be classified or labeled, it can work across anything that's going through SharePoint Embedded.
Absolutely. And we have customers in healthcare, for example, right? So let's say they are building a patent application. They would absolutely label a particular container to be highly confidential, right? At the label, as a label.
Right.
And then every file automatically inherits that. So the application can then enable kind of more restrictive access, including blocking external sharing for this kind of sensitive information.
Right, and we're kind of using SharePoint Embedded now as part of our Copilot experiences today, right?
Yeah.
So why don't you walk through, like, if let's say I walk through all of the new announcements for the last couple of weeks with, you know, search and Copilot chat and create and all of these notebooks and all these things.
Yeah.
Where does SharePoint Embedded fit in all these big in these pictures?
Yeah. So Loop is our most popular first party application built on SharePoint Embedded. And many of the AI-centric applications we saw yesterday during the keynote, including Copilot Pages, Copilot Notebook, the Create experience with Designer, they're all built on SharePoint Embedded.
Okay.
Because they need the ability to have a collaborative experience and be AI ready.
Right.
And they get all of that with SharePoint Embedded. There are many other applications that are getting built on SharePoint Embedded. We like to think it's like the default AI platform for M365 applications.
Right, so it's kind of storing the state of all these different experiences as well as the files. It's got all the basically all the parts that it needs for building your own generative AI apps and also linking, like you said, into Copilot.
Absolutely.
Okay, so in terms of like, you know, SharePoint Embedded, what sets it apart? If you're, say, a developer and you want to build a solution, you've got other options. There are options in Azure, for example, or other places.
Definitely.
Why would I use SharePoint Embedded then for my solution? Like, what's kind of the unique part of doing SharePoint Embedded?
Yeah, I think the unique part is you get the full flexibility in your user experience, right? So the headless SharePoint is actually true in that you get all the capabilities of SharePoint, including Copilot, but then you get to own the application experience. And that's primarily the reason why customers choose SharePoint Embedded when they have a very custom user experience. Okay. So Loop and Copilot notebooks are great examples, right? They could have built on SharePoint,
yeah.
but they needed their own application UX. They needed their own storage that they own, right?
Yeah.
And so from that perspective, that's kind of one of the decision factors that customers typically use. Another scenario is the ISV one, okay. where in a SaaS model, when you're deploying your applications to hundreds of customers, you don't want to rely on some implementation details required for the content management system to be kind of ready before your application.
Right.
With SharePoint Embedded, your application, your ISV application, is ready to go. It's ready to deploy to as many customers as you want to.
Right then, you've got all the full fidelity of the metadata, the labels, all the things, the ACLs, like you said, around those files.
Exactly.
They are all things that you can leverage there. So I guess in terms of kind of AI and Copilot now, we've done a lot of things on agents. I think you had a session doing agent kind of design and building. So how does SharePoint Embedded then interact with or work with when you think about building agents?
Yeah, so SharePoint Embedded is native to the Copilot platform. Mm-hmm. Right, and if you think about any AI platform, there are like three aspects to it, right? One is the AI stack, which is the model, the vectors and the indexes that get created, right?
Mm-hmm.
And then second is the context, the data that makes the AI responses more relevant.
Mm-hmm.
So that storage is typically SharePoint and OneDrive in case of Copilot.
Right.
SharePoint Embedded is yet another partition within the same Microsoft tenant.
Mm-hmm.
So the context that you store in SharePoint Embedded is natively available to the Copilot stack, right?
Okay.
The third aspect of a Copilot system is basically the permission awareness, right? The graph mm-hmm. aspect of it. So we make sure only the users who have permission get the AI responses.
Okay.
And SharePoint Embedded is native to graph as well. And because of that, you get the full Copilot stack within your application.
Okay. And does that mean that also, like, from a search perspective or RAG perspective, we're also, with all the content going to SharePoint Embedded, doing embeddings generation and creating all the dimensions around so we can find and serve that information for a retrieval augmented generation call?
Absolutely.
SharePoint Embedded takes advantage of that too.
Absolutely. Now think about an auditing application that you built on SharePoint Embedded. As an AI application, the auditors will naturally will interact with this content in a natural language.
Right.
The content in SharePoint Embedded is automatically semantically indexed, including the vectorization, chunking, and everything.
Yep.
So you can interact with that content.
Yeah.
Right. Like you would do for a content in SharePoint. More importantly, you don't have to worry about re-indexing it.
Right.
The content is continuously evolving as users who collaborate with it, as your business processes basically touch this data and transform. But this context is now semantically indexed automatically for you. So you don't have to worry about kind of keeping your indexes fresh with respect to the
content. Well, not only that, but because the prompt itself is calculating and embedding on what you're trying to get from the prompts, it's speaking the same language as the search index that basically you're using for all of your SharePoint files, OneDrive, SharePoint Embedded. So the re-indexing, because a lot of times there's basically the language mismatch of, let's say you're using Ada 2 or Ada 3 embedding models somewhere else.
Yeah.
Your prompt needs to speak that model, and then you've got to use something else for M365. This way, it's all compatible and
all
working.
It's all compatible, exactly. Yeah. So you can have an agent that sits within your audit application, mm-hmm. and you can choose for that agent to only reason with content within your audit application.
Right.
Or you can say, I want this knowledge to be available in the Microsoft Copilot system.
Right.
And you can enable a toggle and say, okay, the same information can now be searchable within the Microsoft canvases.
Yeah.
You can publish an agent that sits within Teams or Microsoft 365 Copilot. And then you can have that agent reason with the same auditing information within Microsoft canvases as well. So you get the flexibility as a developer.
Flexibility, the compatibility, it's just going to drop in, it's just going to work, and that's kind of what it gives you as a as the platform effectively for SharePoint Embedded.
Yep.
Great stuff. So okay, so last question. What would you tell anybody who's watching right now they should go do to get started in trying out SharePoint Embedded?
The first thing I would say is give it a try, building your own application, even if you're not a developer. Our sample code and get started instructions are super easy. So it's ak.ms-spe agent.
Mm-hmm.
ak.ms-sp agent has all the instructions you need to build your first agent with just a few lines of code and basically get a sense of it, show it to your stakeholders and decision makers and kind of evolve from there.
Okay, so now we've kind of described all the benefits here with SharePoint Embedded. It kind of respects all of your purview controls, your intra permissions. Can you give us an example of how I might use this? Let's say I'm a user or a developer or a company that wants to build something like this.
Yeah.
What would that look like?
Yeah. Why don't I give some real examples of how customers are using SharePoint Embedded today? I'll give you two different examples, one from a line of business scenario where you're building an application for your own business, for your own employees, and then I'll give you another ISV scenario. All right. So we have a customer in healthcare where they have literally hundreds of applications for their employees. And each application has its own data management system. And that is an IT nightmare, as you can imagine.
Mm-hmm.
And they were looking for something that can unify this documentation layer for them. And more importantly, it's ready for AI, right? So they chose SharePoint Embedded. So as a developer, they chose to store the documents that go for this line of business applications for the pharma employees to be stored in SharePoint Embedded. So they can collaborate with these documents just like they would in SharePoint, but it is in their application. It's their application URL with a completely different UX.
So it could be like their website that has its own panel for that content.
It could be a mobile app.
Mobile app or something else.
Exactly.
Okay. And the other example?
Yes. So another example, which is also very common in SharePoint Embedded customer base, is an ISV scenario. So imagine I am an ISV.
Mm-hmm.
I have an ERP business, and I deal with documents from different systems, and I'm aggregating, right? And I'm offering the aggregated value to my customers. At this point, I need a solution that I can basically store the documents, right? I get to design the information architecture, but I want the documents to stay within the customer's tenancy.
Right.
So as an ISV, SharePoint Embedded is a perfect choice because I get my custom user experience. It could be, you know, ISV XYZ dot, you know, ERP.com.
Mm-hmm.
However, I bring the SharePoint functionalities, I bring the Copilot functionalities within this application. And then once this application is deployed to hundreds of my customers, their data stays within their customer boundary.
Right. So even though they're logged into xyz.com, it's kind of like a secure path into your files that are in your SharePoint boundary.
In your M365 boundary.
Yeah. Yep.
Exactly.
That's pretty cool. So that way you got a way to customize the whole interactive experience and all the things of what they see. It could be branded as your brand, your company, but you're providing something unique, but using their files effectively with a secure way in. And because it's all, like you said, it was all intra and purview enabled and all the auditing's there. If you're, say, doing something with Copilot, all those interactions, everything's logged.
Yes. And that's a strong selling point for many of the ISPs as part of their go-to-market strategy,
mm-hmm.
because they get to say, you own your own data, customer. And that is a huge compliance relief for many of the ISVs and their consuming customers.
Great stuff. Thanks so much for joining us today. Again, I'm Jeremy Chapman, coming to you live from Las Vegas, the Microsoft 365 Community Conference. Be sure to subscribe to our channel for more content like this. We'll see you again soon.